What's up, guys? It's makeup artist Jacrista. Today I'm gonna kind of switch it up a bit. I'm not gonna do a tutorial. I'm not gonna do a wig review. I am going to talk about something that a lot of people ask me about and kind of want me to share with you all. So today I'm going to talk about how I attracted the love of my life. Yes, ladies and gents, if you want to watch, whatever. How I attracted the love of my life. How you can attract the love of your life. First of all, you know how everyone is like, oh, what is that? I want to know the prayer that Sierra prayed to get Russell. I want to know the prayer that Remy prayed to get Pep. Well, first of all, I'm pretty sure that they did some of these steps that I'm about to hip y'all to the game, okay? So, and this is what I did as well, and this is how I attracted the love of my life, the lovely Mr. Harris. So, number one on how to attract the love of your life. And this is a person that God is sending, not the person that you want, not the person that, you know, I don't know, like, that wants you, but you don't want the, how to attract the love of your life. Okay, so number one, you have to start with self-evaluation. All right, guys, so self-evaluation, what I did was I looked over, well, okay, so Keith and I got together in 2016, June of 2016, like around my birthday-ish. So prior to meeting him, I was dating and talking to people. Of course, it didn't work out. Boom. Okay, so we're going to start January 2016. I was talking to somebody. It wasn't going the way that I wanted it to go. The person was playing games. It was just like, ugh, it was a mess. I am a firm believer of karma. So, what you give is what you're gonna get. So, if you give nasty, if you give player, if you give dog, if you give just rude and blah, 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 you're gonna receive that back. So, I have been a player and I have been played. So, I feel like that's what happened in January 2016. So, like I was saying, dating a guy wasn't going the way I wanted to go. I was like, oh my God, this is a waste of my time. Granted, 2 years ago, I was 20. I'm 22 now. So, 19, 20, something like that. So, self-evaluation. I think I had got to the point, no, me and the guy stopped talking. And I was like, God, what am I doing wrong? Why can't you send someone in my life that's equally yoked like me, that is serious like me, that don't want to waste time, and I like them as much as they like me type of thing. So I had to do some self-evaluation. So during this time of self-evaluation, I would pray, I would sit down and think about the things that I need to change about myself within. And to receive what I want, if that makes sense. So I changed, like, I started going to church more. I've always been into church, but started going to church heavy, distance myself from some people. It's okay to fast. I realized that I had like it's weird because it's like I had a detachment, but I hadn't, like, attachment when it came to dudes. I don't know, it's weird. Like, when I self-evaluated, I realized that I wasn't as complete and I wasn't where I wanted to be in order to receive someone. So, yeah. So, one, you have to do self-evaluating. You have to say, oh, okay, my attitude bad about this. I'm going to work on that. Oh, I'm too distant. I need to work on that. Or, oh, I'm too clingy. I need to work on that. Or, do I really love myself the way I think I do? Because you can't expect someone to love you fully if you do not love yourself 100%. 100%. And that goes into number two. So, number two, first, number one is self-evaluation. Number two is self-love / self-care. So self-love is you learning to love yourself 100%. Not 75%, not 50%, not, oh, I love myself, and oh, I'm popping. I love, no, that's not love. Like, do you really love yourself in the core? Do you sit back and think about the way you are and be like, I would date me because, you know, I have great communication skills. I have great morals and value. I have blah, 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 blah. And then another thing with self-love and care, it's okay to, like, you know, take yourself out to eat. I know some people don't like to eat by themselves, but whatever. Take yourself out to eat. Take yourself to the movies. Go to the spa by yourself. Go get your nails done, your toes done by yourself. It's okay to have alone time. It's okay to self-reflect. It's okay to work on yourself. We're here on this earth to become better people. If you're not elevating and you're going backwards or you're staying stagnant, you're not growing. And how do you expect to attract someone or to even love yourself if you're not growing? I know some people that like I see and they're like, oh, you've changed, you're goody two shoes, oh, you done got saved now and blah 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 blah. Okay, yeah, whatever you want to call it, because I did the work. You feel what I'm saying? Me and God worked that thing out. So I don't care if you think, oh, well, she thinks she been this now, or, oh, I don't talk to her no more. Oh, no, because a part of self-love and self-care is removing yourself away from people and things that won't elevate you and take you to the next level. Got it? So and also self-care and self-love has to do with your health. So everybody know I ain't the slimmest thing out there. Still working on it. But like smoking and drinking and cursing and what you're bringing into your temple, whatever come in has to go out. So if you're bringing in cursing and all that rap music now, I listen to rap, but all the people I listen to is like Drake and like some songs that be on the radio. Everything else I'm like R&B, like I'm an old soul. Everybody know it. Like, you don't even know I'm 22. Like, I'm an old soul. But whatever you bring in must come out. So if you're bringing in all that nasty, foul stuff, smoking, excess drinking and stuff. Now, I love a good bottle of wine. I love some vodka. I occasionally like a Henny and strawberry lemonade. Thanks to my cousin, he put me on that. But if you're constantly doing that, you're weighing yourself down. And what does that bring out of you? Negativity. Have you ever been on like Facebook or Instagram or Snapchat and you see people, the only time they're on Facebook is if they're complaining about their life or something. Oh, my baby mama this. Oh, my baby daddy did. And putting that whole life story. You don't have to do that. You have to work on yourself. Self-love. If you had enough self-love and if you had enough love for yourself and respect for yourself, things like that wouldn't even be, no. Mm-mm. Radiating. We're radiating positive vibes. So, what you bring in is what you release. If you bring in positivity, you release positivity. If you bring in negativity, you release negativity. And who wants to be around negative Nancy? It was to the point where before I even start self-reflecting and self-evaluating and this whole process of self-love, I used to get tired of myself. I'm like, you doing the same thing? You messing around with the same person? And it ain't never going nowhere? Like, you praying to God and he's answering you and telling you what you need to do and you still doing the same stuff? So that's when I learned that I needed to do these steps in order to become a better person myself, so and position myself for the blessing and the person that God was sending me. Cool. So that ties into number three. So number three, you have to have your spirituality I believe in Jesus Christ as my Lord and Savior. But some people may not. I don't, we're not getting into that. Spirituality. A lot of praying, a lot of fasting, spending a lot of time with God, and your alone time and doing your self-love, self-care, self-evaluation. You need to do that and abstain from some things. And that's why I said fasting, because fasting, you're sacrificing something that you really like doing or really enjoy doing for the Lord, so, and for him to bless you and so on and so forth. So I did a lot of fasting. So January 2016, I stopped talking to the guy, realized that, okay, Jacrista, you need to get your crap together, because you want a boo. You want a boyfriend. I did not want a boyfriend. I want a husband. So I positioned myself and cleaned myself up, fasted, I abstained from sex for 6 months. And that was a part of my fasting. And that was going to church every Sunday, tithing, Bible study, Bible lab, sprinkle of Jesus, like all that stuff, like heavy, like in the word heavy, because once you change yourself, or once you position yourself to receive your blessings, then God, he just sprinkle them down on you, baby. Sprinkle them down, and then you have to be ready to receive them. Okay, so that's on spirituality. So abstaining, like I said, I abstained for 6 months. Supposed to be longer, but you meet the one you love, child. So January 2016, all that stuff happened. I started praying, fasting, church, and more. I said, okay, you know what? I'm not gonna have sex until my husband comes into my life. And granted, Keith is not my husband yet. So I still kind of messed up, like with, you know, meeting him and falling in love and blah, 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 blah. But what I saw and what I learned in those 6 months, from January to my birthday, which is June, when I met Keith, I learned a lot about myself. I learned that my temper, I learned how to control my temper. I learned how to love myself wholeheartedly. Granted, I still have a lot of things that I need to work on within. But I learned how to accept more. I learned how to trust. Because I used to be like, F these dudes, or I don't trust nobody. And that's why everything was situationship after situationship, until I got to the point where I was like, ooh, I want a boyfriend. And buddy from January, he wasn't trying to be no boyfriend. He was just trying to be a situationship. I was like, you know what? I don't have time for that. Anyway, so I abstained. I became patient. I fasted. I started working out. Your mind gets clearer. Your heart gets clearer. And you're able to hear the Lord speak. And some people are like, well, I haven't experienced it yet. But abstain from some of that stuff and push away from some of those things and all that negativity and stuff, and you will hear the Lord speak. And he will tell you some things that, y'all, it will blow your mind. Like, and he will reveal some things that will blow your mind. Reveal some things about yourself, about other people, about just life in general. And it will blow your mind. And so, next, my final little 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So, my fifth point. You must date. Like, just because you're being abstinent or practicing celibacy like I was for those 6 months, or you're on a spiritual journey and blah, 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 and you're on a, like, self-evaluating stuff, you can still have fun. You're still human. You still have, you know, needs and wants and blah and stuff like that. So date. Like, let me tell you. So, from that 6 month stretch from January 2016 to June, I dated, you know, I dated probably like one or I think two people, but not at the same time. Dated one, and then the next one dated, still didn't do anything, you know, abstaining, no sex, nothing. Went out, had fun. It's okay to date. It's okay to socialize. It's okay to, you know, have a life. Like, we and I rhyme. I'm a millennial. Like, it's okay to, like, go out and date and stuff. You just have to present yourself as such, and they will respect you as such. If you present yourself like a floozy, they will treat you like a floozy. That's just it. So yeah, it's okay to date. It's okay to have friends. But I do reckon one thing that I did was I was dating, and then probably around like I think it was June the 6th, that's when Keith and I met. Y'all will see how we met on my next video. I'm gonna try to bring Keith on here. Met Keith and kind of like start texting and Snapchatting and stuff. Kind of like Keith more than the other guy. And so that same day, me and the other guy stopped talking. Get out of here. And it was something about Keith that, I don't know, like, it intrigued me. And he was really nice. It was like, it intrigued me, but he was so nice. I was like, you too nice. What's wrong with you? What's really wrong with you? And then he was persistent, because that wasn't the first time he reached out to me. Anyways, we'll get to that when he comes on my channel. But, and then that same night that, you know, we met or whatever, or, you know, start talking, we were on the phone from, like, that night. It was a Saturday night because it was my cousin's surprise party. June the 6th, I believe. The weekend of June 6th, something like that, 2016. And we talked that entire night from when I left my cousin's party until Sunday, the next day. Sunday morning at, like, 6 or 7, maybe 8. Of course, we fell asleep on the phone. But we, like, got up, still on phone. Like, hey, you going to church? Yep. You going to church? Yep. I went to church. He went to church. Got out of church. And we've been inseparable ever since. So, I say all that to say, if you follow my 5 steps, I guarantee you, either one, you're going to see some things. You're going to learn a lot of things about yourself that you didn't even know or that you already knew. And you just threw it in the back of your mind. Threw it in the back burner. Like, oh, psh, I ain't got to worry about that. No. Because you need to start cleaning up your mess now. Your baggage now. So when God blesses you with that person or blesses you with that thing that you really, really want, you'll be prepared to receive it. So either that or you're gonna meet the one. Those 5 steps is how I met the one. I knew Keith was the one that night when we were on the phone for that long amount of time. And then we woke up the next day, we're still on the phone with each other, and both of us went to church and then talked to each other after. So that's how I knew he was the one, and we've been together ever since. And another thing is, you know, when you're meeting that person or when you get that thing that you've done all that cleaning up for and preparing to receive for, don't forget about God, because you wouldn't have that blessing if it wasn't for him. A lot of people will go to church and do this and do that just to be like, I'm gonna do right, blah blah. Okay, you do right for that amount of time, then God bless you with it, and then you throw God to the back burner, and that ain't cool, because at the end of the day, he's the one that can take it away from you at the blink of an eye. So I always make sure that, even now 2 years later, I always make sure that Keith and I are praying for each other. I thank God that he brought Keith into my life. I thank God that Keith harassed me I'm joking. Y'all will hear that story when he come on the channel, on the show, channel, whatever. I thank God for all of that, and I owe it all to him, because without him, I would not have my future husband, and my soulmate. And I feel like, and I know that God has told me before that that's your husband. I said, oh yeah? He's like, yeah, that's your husband. I said, okay. And we've been rocking ever since. And he told me that. And when I tell y'all, like, months into Keith and I, like, we okay, so we met in June. Got in a relationship July 3rd. June 2016. Got in a relationship July 2016. Been rocking ever since. Relationship, best relationship I've ever been in. All because I did those five steps. I've done the work. So once you do the work, you get rewarded. And you have to continue to do the work now that you have that thing. And you have to continue to better yourself and work on yourself and believe in yourself, and you will achieve. So we've been rocking ever since. And so that's been 2 years and eternity to go. So guys, I just really wanted to share my five kind of like bullet points or things onto how to attract the person or the thing that you're looking for, the person of your dreams, your future husband, your future wife. I hope this video was inspirational. I hope you learned something from this. I hope you follow my five steps and let me know how it worked out for you all. You can always comment in the boxes below. Don't forget to add me on Instagram, Snapchat, Facebook, MUA Jacrista. And you know, just let me know how y'all feel about that. Was that a good segment? Was it good enough for you? Anyways, guys, thank you so much for listening. So don't forget, you have self-evaluation. You have to love yourself / self-care, spirituality, abstain. So you have to abstain. And don't forget to date, guys. Mingle. It's okay to mingle, but you still got to be. You have to abstain. So your vision and things can be clear, because sex and stuff like that cloud your vision. So while you're on this journey to better yourself, you don't need anything clouding your vision. And I know that it's going to be hard. It is hard as crap. But you have to keep your eye on the prize, because at the end of the day, you wanted that. I'm giving y'all the tips. I'm giving you the tips. And everybody's like, well, what's that prayer that Sierra prayed to get Russell? What's the prayer that Remy prayed to get Papoose? And what's the prayer that... trying to tell y'all, they probably have done what I've just told you, these five things. So guys, that's all for today. Thank you for watching my channel. All the information, I just gave it to you. Don't forget to hit the like and subscribe button, and I will see you all soon.